76 is here again with spirit strong and in my dream. Equality, democracy. So let's bring that liberty bell. Bring that liberty bell.
Was written by our good friend, engulfing pal, Curt Massey. Thank you, Curt, for a great song. Now here's a new arrangement of one of the biggest songs in recent years. Gentlemen, are you ready? A one and two and
and the Champagne Music Makers having a lot of fun with Tony Orlando's great hit, Tie a Yellow Ribbon Around the Old Oak Tree If You Still Think of Me. And some wonderful trombone by Bob Havens from Quincy, Illinois, and clarinet by Henry Cuesta from Corpus Christi, Texas. Next, Canadian Sunset with the Curt Ramsey Quintet and Tanya in the feature spotlight.
You came In case you didn't recognize everyone in the group, it included Charlie Pallotta, Dick Dale, Gail Farrell, and Sandy Griffith. Also, Tanya and Curt. You know, Gail and her husband, Ron Anderson, now live in Nashville, Tennessee, with their twin daughters, Lauren and Erin. Sandy, with her husband, Brent Griffith, live in Thousand Oaks, California, with their seven children. Now, that may seem like a big family to you, but not to me, because I am one of 13. Next is a fine pianist, Bob Smale. He can play anything. And here he is with a great arrangement of Cottonfields, with Neil Levang on guitar, Richard Maloof on bass, and Jack Immel on the drums. So, fellas, let's hear it.
A music major from the University of California at Berkeley, and I still find it hard to believe what he does on the piano. Now let's listen to two more well-schooled musicians as they team up for one of Stephen Foster's best-loved melodies, Bob Ralston and Charlotte.
Mm-hmm.
stress and very relaxing. Next, America's number one young dance couple, Cissy and Bobby, with one of their many wonderful routines.
Bobby and Cissy, speaking as one dancer to another, they were terrific. You know, Cissy King has retired from show business and is now involved in public relations in the Los Angeles area. And Bobby, of course, is still dancing with his partner, Elaine. Remember the Semonski sisters? There were six of them, all young and very pretty when they were on the show. I think Michelle was 6 and a half when they first started. I can remember in 1981, while on tour, this very beautiful young lady came backstage to have a visit with Lawrence Welk. He had no idea who she was. Well, it turned out to be Michelle Semonski, all grown up and very pretty. Now here are the girls to sing for you, A Never-Ending Song of Love.
Thank you.
Semonski sisters and Henry Cuesta. They make a fine combination, a great team. Now let's hear from the very popular young man from Bloomington, Minnesota, Tom Netherton.
Here's a beautiful song by Gordon Jenkins. And you know, it has a beautiful, beautiful message for all of us. Hope you like it.
As I approach the prime of my life, I find I have the time of my life. Learning to enjoy at my leisure all the simple pleasures, and so I happily conceive. This is all I ask, this is all I need. Beautiful girl,
Tom. We should record that one. Our country gal, Ava Barber, gains new fans every week, and rightfully so. She sings better all the time. And here she is with a country favorite.
Just hanging around.
Thank you, Ava. Ava and her husband, Roger Sullivan, live in Knoxville, Tennessee. In fact, there's a whole bunch of Welk stars now living in Tennessee. The Aldridge sisters live in Knoxville. Sally Flynn and her husband, Clay Hart, live in Nashville. Also in Nashville is Lawrence Welk's very good friend, Lon Barnell, who used to take us on tour every year. Now we're going to hear from a very pretty lady, Señorita Anacani. My Spanish isn't all that good, but here goes the title, El Cumbanchero.
To discover her down in Escondido. The familiar hymns are always high on our request list, especially this one by Norma and Jimmy.
Soft as a voice of an
pleasure of doing a number with my good friend Larry Hooper, one of the best liked people in our musical family, not only by our fans, favored by his fellow performers. Hoopy, shall we slide into the number?
Just like I wrote it, cousin. Bless you.
Well, that's the little dance that Lawrence likes so much. Hoopy liked it, too. We had to have a special top made for the piano so that I could do the slides easily. And Hoop and I used to have a lot of fun with it. We had a running dialogue going. I can hear him now. Cousin, you're getting just a little too close. And I'd say, look out, Hoop, because here I come again. You know, it seems as though I've been dancing all my life. Well, I hope not all of my life. But I can remember dancing on street corners in Pasadena, California, where I grew up as a little kid. And you know, later on, after I'd worked around a number of years, I had the opportunity to go to Europe, tour there, and tour Australia, where I met Ken Delo. And as fate would have it, we both end up back in the States on the Lawrence Welk show. I remember auditioning for Lawrence Welk at the Hollywood Palladium, where he and the band were playing. Lawrence put me on the show, then he brought me back again, and brought me back again and again. And you know, I ended up working on the show for 18 years. Now that's a pretty good run. Lawrence, thank you. Now let's hear from my old friend Ken Delo, who's not going to sing an Australian song or an Aussie song, but he's going to do his version of an Al Jolson favorite, Swanee. Take it away, Ken.
One of the greatest entertainers of all time was the son of a rabbi, and he himself studied to be a cantor, but it wound up he was known as the great jazz singer. I'm sure you'll all know who I mean when you hear this song.
I've been away from you a long time. I never thought I'd miss you so. Somehow I feel your love is real. Near you I long to be. The banjo's coming soft and low. That banjo's coming soft and low. Somehow I feel your love is real. I long to be Swanee. How I love you, how I love you, my dear old Swanee. I'd give the world to be among the folks, yeah, D-I-X-I, even now my man.
by me is waiting for me, praying for me, down by the Swanee. The folks up north will see me no more when I get to that Swanee shore. Swanee, Swanee, oh, I'm coming home to Swanee. Mammy, Mammy, oh, I love the old folks at home. Swanee, how I love ya, how I love ya, my dear old Swanee. The folks up north will see me no more.
And who can forget the great Al Jolson? I still remember him so well because he was the first entertainer I saw when I left the farm. The show Fiddler on the Roof tells the story of a Jewish family in Middle Europe. Joe Feeney sings one of the wonderful songs from this great show. Beautiful song and a fine rendition, Joe. Now I'm going to ask our musical director, George Cates, to take over. George.
Thank you, Lawrence. For our Jewish friends who are celebrating Rosh Hashanah, I'd like to play a medley of Israeli folk dancers, Senet Sena and Hava Nagila. We'd like to feature Russ Klein on the clarinet and Johnny Zell on the trumpet.
Thank you.
George, that was terrific. Not only did Lawrence like to dance, play the accordion, and lead the band, he also wrote songs. When his first daughter was born, he wrote a song, and it turned out to be the band's theme song. Now he's written another one. And here are Gail, Sandy, and Mary Lou to tell you about it.
Lawrence has done very well for himself since leaving the farm in Strasburg, North Dakota, 52 years ago.
He started out as a one-man band back in 1924, but he kept building and building until now he has a musical family of over 50 people. Not only that, he also has this very successful television show. It's been on the air over 26 years. Isn't that great?
Right now, he's got us a little concerned and worried because it looks like the maestro has turned songwriter. And we just hope this doesn't destroy his career.
And ours.
You've heard the saying, you can take the boy out of the country, but you can't take the country out of the boy. Lawrence calls this song the Strasburg Strut.
Folks, listen to these lyrics.
Each Independence Day, the hometown band would play down on the village square. Everyone in town was there. Then came the big parade, and how that town band played, dodging every main street rut.
For all over here, because Chet O'Connor the other day when we played golf at Bel Air, he made a hole in one on the 10th hole, 200 yards, one of the first holes that's been made there for a long, long time. And I said, I'm going to put you on television. So a nice hand for the judge.
Thank you, Mark. Thank you.
Good job, thank you. And those young ladies were Karen and Laura Schwab, my nieces from North Dakota. You can see how I still have fond memories of my old hometown, but I must confess, I did have a little help with those lyrics from George Tao, a member of our production staff. We recently had the pleasure of taking our musical family back to Jamestown, North Dakota, and here's a North Dakota song we get many requests for. It was written by George Cates and dedicated to my home state.
Why did I ever roam? Why did I roam far away?
Let's ring that bell for all that's good. Let's ring that bell for brotherhood. Let's ring that bell for harmony. We gotta ring that liberty bell for you and me.
Gonna keep her strong, this great big land. Gonna right the wrong with a helping hand. We'll do our part for all to see. We're gonna ring that liberty bell for you and me.
Now 76 is here again.
Well, folks, that's our show for this week. I hope you enjoyed it. I certainly enjoyed being here with you. Now stay tuned for previews of our next week's show. Till then, keep a song in your heart and a shine on your shoes. So long.
Good night. Good night. Until we meet.
Since it first appeared on Great Performances, Brideshead Revisited has become a symbol of life lived by privileged class Britons in the years between the two world wars. Tonight at 9 here on 6, Brideshead Revisited reappears for an encore presentation. Silver Screen, tonight featuring the Dirty Dozen, will be shown at 10 o'clock.
Happy feet.
Presentation of